the world is changing very, very quickly. It's becoming absolutely essential to use technology.
We are getting to a point now where you basically aren't able to go to have education, health, almost any aspect of life is dependent on information technologies.
ICT is absolutely fundamental to be able to work and to be able to access a whole range of things that we need for day-to-day living.
And yet there is also this massively quickly increasing technology gap.
So often the technologies are making us feel stupid, and for many individuals, especially people who are getting older, they're being confronted with more and more technologies they just can't use.
Aegis comes from, as a name, from ancient Greece, meaning the protection shield, and also a goddess, a Greek goddess, that was protecting the family and those at disadvantage. This is exactly what we are aiming to do. Aegis aims to empower the disadvantaged user, whether disabled, elderly, or any person in disadvantage, to be able to use in an optimal way the mobile technology, the mobile phone, their internet, including rich internet applications, or a simple desktop PC, with mainstream technology, not having to use any costly or any other special technology.
As a disabled person, I think that Aegis will allow me to work more efficiently, because I will have better devices to work on the desktop and on my mobile, and will allow my work to be more optimum, no? To optimize my work and allow other people to work as well, even if they have severe disabilities like me.
As an individual who might have a disability, I have many, many needs. I don't fit into these clean categories, sort of disability categories. And one of the great things about Aegis is I can make adjustments. I can seamlessly adjust the interface, adjust whether it's a mobile, a desktop, or a web interface, to my own personal needs, to the specific things that in this context, at this time, I need.
Every user, every type of user, has different socioeconomic behavioral needs and wants in the different areas.
So part of the goal of all of these efforts is to figure out how to have interfaces that will automatically adapt to you when you come up to them, so that you're able to use them.
Up till now, we've tended to have specialist assistive technology, as it's called, that's developed independently of the mainstream.
These technologies are quite expensive and exclusive. Apart from the cost involved, users may oftentimes are depending on assessment services that may be quite time-consuming for them to wait for.
The things that people need, if they're using alternative access systems, to be able to get online, to do all of these essential activities, are not keeping up with the standard development that is happening out there.
In Aegis for web applications, we are going through the accessibility framework step by step in all of the various aspects of our work. We are, of course, defining what accessible means in web applications. We are developing a number of stock component sets that are accessible, things like jQuery, a very popular component set, MooTools, Fluid Infusion, and of course JavaFX for the web. We are doing developer tool support in NetBeans for creating accessible applications using these component sets. We are building support for ARIA and other accessibility definitions in the web browsers like Firefox. We are creating a number of accessible sample web apps. And then we are connecting these through Firefox to assistive technologies.
At Code Factory, we are making mobile phones accessible to the blind and visually impaired. We are doing screen readers, screen magnifier, GPS application. And the ultimate goal that we share with Aegis is that we want to provide accessible solutions for mainstream devices. When you want to make a screen reader, which is a native code application, for mainstream devices, you can do it either if you have an accessibility API, but unfortunately, there is no mobile platform today with a good accessibility API. So the other option is to have access to very low level of the operating system. And that's what we like about the IAGIS project, that they are thinking about this key question, so that third party developers like us could benefit from this accessibility API and make mobile phones accessible to the blind and visually impaired.
As AEGIS has deliverables for both mobile, web, and desktop, mobile will benefit substantially from the work from AEGIS. There are three primary areas. One is information resources, things like personas, use cases, contextual ontologies that help assistive technology vendors, mainstream developers, and even industry more effectively understand the needs of persons with disabilities, so you can more effectively design solutions for that customer. The second area would be embedded technologies, things like text-to-speech on Java mobile phones, which doesn't exist today, and accessibility APIs that would help provide programmatic exposure to enable effective accessible development. And in terms of applications, the sample applications, they're not meant to compete with commercial applications. The example of screen readers, the AEGIS deliverable of a screen reader is meant to demonstrate. It's not meant to compete with commercial applications. It's a teaching tool, and it's also utility for individuals who perhaps couldn't have afforded a screen reader, or the mobile phone they have, perhaps there wasn't a screen reader available. So it's meant to complement, not compete with existing technologies.
I think developing the technology is one thing. Distributing it and helping people to use it is another thing. And I think this is where assistive technology has had difficulties in the past. It's the process of making that software available at the right price, and also to the right people.
The main problem at this moment with people with disabilities is that, in fact, they have access to assist technology, but the appropriate training is missing. So often they buy a product, or it's being sold to them, often for a lot of money, and then actually they never get support afterwards to know how to properly use those assist technologies.
What I hope that AEGIS will produce is, first of all, low-cost technology, which will enable a larger number of people to be able to use a variety of assistive technology that they couldn't afford otherwise. And I can see the project enabling users to take control of their own technology.
The advantage with Dasher, where essentially all of the letters move from the side of the screen across, so you effectively see a string of words appearing, is that you're looking where you're going. So with the gaze, if you're following your line of sight, then you should be able to see the word, and you don't have to look somewhere else on the screen like many other systems. The expensive solutions, or the current solutions available on the market, tend to need very powerful hardware, so high resolution cameras, infrared lighting, high frame rates, whereas we're hoping to infer gaze position just from a cheap webcam, and so the price differences with all that hardware is quite high.
We have two important developments for people with visual impairments on the desktop. One is converting word processing documents to Braille, and another is converting word processing documents to digital talking books in the DAISY format. For converting word processing documents to DAISY, we have developed an extension for an open source word processor. This is openoffice.org Writer. And this extension allows you to convert text documents directly to DAISY books without leaving the editing environment.
Es fundamental que la Comisión Europea apueste por este tipo de proyectos, es decir, tiene que ser algo en este sentido desde todo el continente y llegando a todas las regiones y localidades. El apostar es el cumplir, el tener claro que las personas con discapacidad tienen derecho a participar en sociedad y si no cuentan con el requisito previo, con la condición sine qua non de que las tecnologías sean accesibles, sin duda se producirá una injusticia, a la vez se vulnerará un derecho, pero sobre todo se eliminará lo que es la participación social de estas personas.
For making the GNOME Shell UI libraries implement the GNOME Accessibility Framework, I am delighted to give the award.
AEGIS is a community of many researchers. There's no way that any one group can do it alone.
Trying to build accessibility into all of the different information technologies we have is too broad for any one country to tackle. And so seeing the collaborative efforts, AEGIS, combines people in the United States and Canada and Europe all together to try to create access solutions for all of us.
So much of AEGIS and the Open Accessibility Framework involves people and groups working together with one another. The folks who are making the user interface component sets feed into the developer tools, feed into the applications that we create. So it's critical that we have the ability to sit down, work things out, understand what one group is doing for another. The application can say, these are the components I need to make my app. When we're making assistive technologies, it's important to be able to check our work at the end, because at the end of the day, it's the user that counts.